Hi there! I hope you found names that you agreed on, and your teacher can help you if you haven't. In fact, if you're not sure about the names of your crayfish, you don't know what to do next, raise your hand and get help from your teacher right now. But if you have the names of your crayfish, awesome! So, next step, you need to write in your science notebook. Your science notebook needs to earn a check, a title, a date, a picture, a sentence. That's what your science notebook needs. When you're getting those things, this is where they are. Crayfish names. That's the title of your notebook page. You write that at the top. The date is today's date, and you can put that up there. Then you're going to need a picture and a sentence today. The sentence I came up with for you is this. Blank or hmm is the crayfish with hmm. So you could say if you named your crayfish Henry and he has red on his fan tail, the mermaid tail, you could write, Henry is the crayfish with red on his tail. And then maybe what you would do then is draw a picture for me of Henry, your crayfish, and you would color in the tail red. And then over here, you would say, Julie is the crayfish with long antenna. And you would then draw Julie for me. And off of her head, you would give her really long antennas. And that's what we're doing right now. So your job is to tell me the names of your crayfish and tell me how you can tell them apart. Now, why are we doing this? Because we're still trying to learn that big, big, big idea. The big idea is what structures help you tell your crayfish apart. And so those things like the tail or the antenna, those are the structures of your crayfish. And by picking out a name for your crayfish and figuring out how to tell them apart, you started learning about the structures of crayfish. And that's our big learning goal. Names are really important too, because you need a name to talk about your crayfish. So that's your learning today. Title is crayfish names, the date, and two sentences, two pictures. And you can always write a different sentence. This is the idea to get you started. This is your notebook where you write what you are learning. One more thing. The very, very, very exciting thing about what we're trying to call personalized learning is that if you get this section done, this is section two for crayfish, you can do section three if you want. It's okay. You can just go on to section three. No matter what, if that timer is up there on the board and it's still going for the first 30 minutes, you need to keep working. So if you finish this and that timer says there's 7 minutes left, it's time for you to do more work until the end of the 30 minutes. Even if that timer goes off, you could choose to keep working if you're enjoying your work. So that's why we're doing personalized learning, is that you get a lot of choices in there. And remember, anytime you have questions, ask your teacher. Thank you.